Hello everybody, and welcome back to Tales of Berseria. On the last episode, we stole the ship and dragged this kid along with us. And so now, I think we just need to go talk to everybody. Also, as of right now, as I'm recording this, the DLC with the swimsuits and stuff are out.
You certainly didn't leave them much of a port, though. I wonder if the town will ever recover.
How much did you tell them?
I had just started episode 2, Magilu's Fury, wherein the beautiful witch is captured and tortured by a demon most cruel!
I'm starting to see why they wanted to execute you.
Yeah.
You seem busy.
We need more hands. We have to set our course and tie down the cargo. I've unfurled the sails. Does that not look safe to you?
Sure. As long as it doesn't come loose. Our destination is Logris. Set a course.
I'll do what I can, but this vessel really needs a bigger crew. We need to hire more men. Besides, if we keep sailing this way...
If we keep sailing this way, what? I guess we'll find out.
Velvet! How's our heading?
Oh, this is so hard to read.
Actually, you're holding it wrong. It's built to function even if the ship is rolling.
The heading's fine! Kid, what's your name?
Number 2.
Not that. Your real name. Surely you have one. Wanna hold it?
If that's an order...
I'm asking you what you want.
So you're... ordering me to answer?
Right. You Malakim would destroy yourselves as long as it was an order, wouldn't you?
That is our purpose.
You really are tools. In that case, keep your mouth shut.
Ifrit's pirate crew.
They've got a bead on us, folks. And in case you hadn't noticed, we aren't really equipped for sea combat.
To land, then. We can fight them there.
I mean, a certain someone could cast a spell.
Look at that. They really are a bunch of demons. That works in our favor.
You knowingly pick fights with demons? Must have a death wish.
You're in trouble now that we're on land.
Wipe them out, number 2. That's an order.
Whoa there. We're not the one you'll be fighting.
Is that who I think it is? Yeah, it's him.
It'll be me.
A Moloch?
No, I'm the Reaper.
What is this guy?
A Moloch pirate?
A sword, twin blades, and paper. No pendulum that I can see.
Double 11, he's resistant to water.
Too slow.
Crash through! Too slow!
Well, how's that? Let's go!
Too slow! Too slow! Too slow! Too slow!
Hold up! Let's go!
Wait. I have to refigure myself out with these controls. Hey, number two. Beating him up so much he ran away. Oh man. Get up.
You passed the test. Join us.
Well, aren't you the impudent one?
Says the demon who torched Televis.
You knew about that?
I hope you realize we're doing you a favor. If you'd stayed on that course, you would have smashed right up against the gate of Vortigern.
You guys are headed for Midgand, aren't you? That means you're gonna have to go through the narrows up ahead. But the kingdom has a massive fortress there built to defend them. With a tremendous gate.
A fortress.
If this is true, we're in your debt.
We desire to pass through as well, but we lack the strength. I propose we form a partnership.
I'd be a fool to blindly trust the words of a pirate.
Do you really want to see the gate for yourself? We won't stop you. We'll even throw you a nice funeral if you like.
We're allowed to refuse?
Your business is your business, and ours is ours. There's nothing more to say.
But first mate, you can't go alone. We'll all come with you.
You'd only get in the way. Stick to the plan and focus on your duties aboard the Von Eltia.
So, he seems to be a hand-to-hand combat fighter, which I like. The stronger the foe, the lower the chances of inflicting added effects, of course. But there are ways to improve these chances, for example, exploiting enemy weakness, obviously. Try to inflict status ailments on stunned enemies. Try to stun enemies afflicted by status ailments. Lower enemies' abilities and try to inflict corresponding status ailments. Use break souls and other methods of guard breaking. If you possess a Daredevil's Venet, and earn high grade in consecutive battles in the same location on normal or higher difficulty, a rare high dangerous enemy may enter the fray. These are called dire enemies. Because other foes are invincible in their presence, they are a challenge to defeat. But they can't be fled from. Why would you... Achieve victory against these fearsome opponents and you earn valuable items, piles of gold, and tons of grade. So, any other foes that show up in the battle can't be defeated until you defeat a dire foe that's in the battle. Dire foes appear more often if the battle difficulty is higher. Hard has 5 times the chance of normal. More grade has been earned based on the average across recent battles. More battles have been fought in the area. If you could manipulate that if you wanted to, if it's based on the grade, about your average. Searching in areas you have outgrown may be helpful as well. Hmm.
Tragically, your favorite witch is neither a sailor nor a warrior. All she can really do is look on.
No argument there.
Is the Gate of Vortigern really something that impressive, Dial?
They've got a fortress and a patrolling fleet, but the gates is the real show. Even a battleship couldn't blast its way through that thing.
Is there no sea route that avoids the Narrows?
There is, so to speak, but it's a long way out into the open sea. We just end up shipwrecked.
That pretty much tells you all you really need to know. Where is... what you got? Amber Blade, Amber Talismans. Ooh, I should pick up some of this while I'm here. That way I can make some dishes. Actually, let's see if we can enhance anything. We can enhance this plain paper. That's it. And I can't enhance anything any further right now either.
And what are you folks planning anyway?
Like I said, we're getting through that gate. If you're not helping us, then the conversation's over.
Is it possible to get through?
If the first mate says he'll do it, he'll do it.
You sure put a lot of faith in him. He's a Moloch, isn't he?
That doesn't matter. He's got the captain's blessing, and that's enough for us.
Couldn't you ignore the Narrows and just sail around?
Not now. We lost both our compass and several of our crew in an earlier attack.
Compass?
Huh.
But in the end, we're pirates. If someone blocks our way, we can't just fall back.
And that's what makes a pirate, huh?
I mean, you kind of made us lose our compass when you blasted our ship.
True enough. If forward lies destruction and backward lies doom, sideways is your only option.
And yet you don't feel like helping out.
I sure don't.
That Moloch isn't all he seems. Who knows what's up his sleeves?
The kid's a Moloch, too. Hey, boy, you sense anything?
We both have ulterior motives. In any case, let's go
He's
after
He's still keeping
him.
Quiet, because she ordered him to.
I know you probably won't listen to me, but you shouldn't get involved with Ifrit's pirates. Ifrit is the fiercest, most villainous pirate in all the seas. Every sailor trembles at his name.
For a demon, you're pretty wimpy.
Demon or not, scary is scary.
So this Ifrit is that tough?
You bet. Rumor has it he's an unrepentant troublemaker and is as strong as an ogre. His gang are all fearless, wild rogues. They've turned the tables on the Royal Navy time and time again. And best of all is their ship, the Von Eltia. She's a legend that's traveled to distant lands across the sea.
Nice. Sounds like I'd get along with them just fine.
You seem to know an awful lot about them yourself.
Well, it's just that every sailor dreams of being as wild and free as Ifrit and his pirate crew.
I guess.
Hey, I can dream, can't I? Demon or human or even lizard, we all got our fantasies.
Okay. I wonder if this guy is Edna's brother. Ooh, finally a save point. Now, I haven't seen one of those in a minute. And by in a minute, I mean I haven't ran across one in a while. Before the attack on Tel Aviv, I think. When we get some more party members, then I'll go and I'll start using the DLC outfits. I just don't feel like there's a point in using them right now, as we don't have very many party members, so we haven't really... Oh.
I'll end this quickly.
They're weak to win. Alright. Keep forgetting that that is no longer a block button. I'm so not used to enemies being smart enough to block. I like it. But it still manages to surprise me. Dang it.
Your style is really unique.
Oh, look, the spider ones are back. It's still weird that we don't have a preemptive strike. Same weakness. Maybe everything here is weak to wind. So easy. They are so easy. But I came over here to see if there was anything here. Just a bunch of souls. Oh, hey, a scorpion enemy. What are you weak to? Wind as well. That was just a really dumb idea on your part. Ooh. Alright.
We're finished here. Let's go.
At least I know how to trigger your weak points. Alright, let's get to that star and see what's up. I hope the game eventually gets to a point where I actually need to turn my teammates on to attack. Because I'm going to be increasing the difficulty as I feel like I need to. But I'm not one of those people who like to torture myself early on by making things extremely difficult for no reason. I like things to get progressively more difficult. Instead of keeping it on one difficulty or just starting it off hard, scale your skill level. The enemies here are just easy. That's just how it is. But it's the bosses I'm more concerned about.
So, you've chosen to trust a pirate?
Not for a second. But if you're prepared to lend us the use of your ship and crew until we reach the capital, we'll help you.
I'll agree to those terms. But there's something I should tell you first. I bring ill fortune to all those around me. The Reaper's curse. I could flip this coin 1,000 times and still land on tails. Trying to get through the fort cost the lives of 5 good sailors. If you join up with me, I can't guarantee your safety.
Why would you go out of your way to warn us?
Even demons don't want to meet an unfair death, right? If you still want to come with me, just know the risks.
Works for me. I land on tails, I'll flip it to heads on my own.
Your name?
Velvet. This is number two.
I'm Rokuro. A pleasure.
Aizen.
Yep, that's Aizen's brother.
You've got a plan of attack, I'm sure. Let's hear it.
To put it bluntly, Vortigern is impregnable. It won't fall to an attack whether by sea or by land.
So, no plan?
Wait, what about both at once?
Exactly. First, we send in the Von Eltia to draw their fleet out of the Narrows. Then we slip inside and open the sea gate ourselves. The Von Eltia will then break away and rush back into the channel. We'll climb aboard and push through.
One slip and we're all as good as dead.
Then don't slip and we're not dead.
Walking with the Reaper, huh?
The plan is already in motion. Let's move. This cave leads to the fortress.
Oh. Well, isn't that convenient? Well, let's get this straightened out right now. Don't do stuff. Our party's starting to come along a little nicely, wouldn't you say? Ooh, we have more souls around here. You get tired, but it's only like in one spot, like per se your eyes. It's kind of annoying. Okay, oh, and so are these guys.
Forget the pain and move.
What, you want to fight, little seed? Ow. Scorpion. How rude. You need guard rate minus 75%. I feel like the ending always attacks for whatever your weak spot is. Which is kind of absurdly overpowered, if you really think about that. It's not exactly a very balanced thing, if that's the case. But I'm not sure if it makes sense or not for that to be the case. But that is how it seems.
Look at all these vines. They're too tangled to cut through.
I'm carrying some flint. Just burn through it.
Do you really think this is a good place for us to start a fire?
Normally, no. But we're also demons and Malachim. Get what I'm saying?
Yeah. We're not exactly normal ourselves.
Burning vines. You can use kindling to burn vines and other obstacles to open a way forward. You can also burn vines on rocks to examine them. Huh. Cool. There are multiple. multiple ways I can go, but which is the wrong way? I don't know which is the wrong way. Burn. And I'll take all of these. Oh, and this. Can't forget that. This is the right
kid's
way.
Awfully quiet. You think maybe there's something wrong with him?
Number two's always that way.
Stop that. Calling him by a number is cruel.
What's Rokuro mean?
Well, son number six, technically.
Same thing then.
Not even remotely. You all right, kid?
Why didn't you say something? If Aizen hadn't noticed in time, you'd be dead.
Because you ordered me to keep my mouth shut.
That's not what I meant. Why? Why would you do that?
Whoa, take it easy, Velvet.
Let me guess, kid. You were bound by an exorcist? I thought as much. The boy's will has been sealed away. Malakim have individual personalities, just like humans. But exorcists have developed methods to seal those personalities away, so they can use Malakim as uncomplaining tools.
Will he always be like this?
Can't say. I've never seen one escape the exorcist before.
And then these things just pop out of nowhere.
Listen, kid, if you're ever in trouble, speak up, okay?
If I'm in trouble?
All right, well, that's over. Time for these things to die. I mean, I guess I could. They're too easy.
I wish I had power like that.
I'd forget about it if I were you.
All right, skit time.
Exorcists bind Malakim's free will.
Yeah. We've lived in this land a long time, and we're our own folk, just like humans. Only a small portion of humans, those with strong resonance, like the exorcists, were able to perceive our existence.
But the Advent changed that.
Now Malakim can be seen by ordinary people. We're being robbed of our free will and made into obedient tools. Humans praise Artorias for providing a miraculous new weapon against demons. But Malakim aren't mere objects.
Malakim aren't things?
They are. As far as Artorias is concerned, Malakim, demons, and humans are all nothing more than tools. Everything in service to his utopia of reason. That's all anyone is to him. Even my brother.
Oh, Velvet, relax a bit. You're gonna go gray with all of that rage. I try to go the wrong way, and it always seems like I go the right way. It's so strange. Well, probably never going to use that one. But thanks anyway, little kitty. Oh look, a gap I can't cross. Which means I'm going to try to check back the other way, because I don't like that green exclamation mark. I've got some more exploring to do. After all, we gotta explore the dungeons. There's sometimes secret hidden chests and stuff, you know? Always gotta explore a dungeon. You don't just run to your destination, you miss some good stuff. Most of the time, anyway. Sometimes there's just absolutely nothing there and you waste your time going out of the path. Burn it! Yeesh. Hey man, you chill. You chill out. You... Man. This place is infested by the most irritating of monsters. Keep it up and I'm gonna end up slaughtering you all. Huh. Leo can't cross here either. Lame. Well, I got more souls, I got more little items and materials. So, it's not a complete waste of time. Alright, this way. Burn it to a crisp. Alright, what's left? The fact that this is a save point here means something's up ahead. Oh, hey, it's the turtles. It's the turtles. I'll use this one. Hey man, it's the turtles. Let's go talk to the turtles. I don't know how they talk like that.
Turtles! Turtles!
Are you a turtle demon or something?
No, you got it all wrong. I'm the white turtles. Sorry about spooking you, Zol.
If you're not a demon, then perhaps you're a Moloch.
Nope, I'm just a plain old turtles. Nothing more and nothing less. I'm sure you guys have lots of questions about me, but for now, I'd appreciate it if you could hold off on them.
Right. Sure, if you insist.
Much obliged.
The turtles are traveling merchants of considerable savvy. Their services could be quite useful for members of the underworld like us.
You don't say. Sounds handy.
You betcha! And that old white turtle shop! We believe the customer's smile is what matters most. That being said, this being where it is, my prices unfortunately might be a little on the high.
Oh no, you're going to give us a bargain.
I'd love to do that, Zeez. But when you do's business out in remote areas like this, the costs add up and, well,
You're just taking advantage of the situation.
I can't entirely deny that, but...
Then that settles it. You'll do business with us at market prices, and that's final.
We should seal the deal with a smile, too, since it matters so much to him. This.
Much obliged.
Amber Talisman, huh? Yeah, he doesn't use magic. I'll grab another one anyway. Amber Bag, what's this? Strange. A little battle garb. And we'll live. I don't know what to do here. Alright, I think actually that's good enough. Let's see. 5 life bottles. Just to be on the safe end. And we're good. Alright, I think this is the best time to call an episode. That was, it was okay. There wasn't really much that went on in this episode, but it was, we got a new party member. That's cool. Alright, well, that is all the time we have for this episode of Tales of Berseria. If you like this episode, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you all on the next episode.